Choose your fighter! Corona plant!
What is up, Manchester? We are picking up where we left off from last time. I'll be the streamer and the caster for tonight. And believe we have six stocks. They have four. So we have two whole guys. They have the Bowser. And they also have a mystery pocket character we don't know of. So that's all that's happening. I'm kind of just joining the loop too, so I don't know too much of what's happening. I wasn't there for their game yesterday, and for those who don't know why I kind of just joined in late, Nintendo had maintenance, so they had to just presume today. So that's what's going on. So now we're going to lead it to Matt versus this Bowser, and Clay just did amazing work before this match started, so this Bowser's only got one stock. Definitely looking forward to what Grimbo could offer, especially since not many players know this plant matchup. And that's usually when we throw out Matt, is when they lack that matchup knowledge. So I'm curious to see how good or not so good they play against the Piranha Plant. Leading off, Matt's doing an amazing job zoning this Bowser out. Feels like Cloud is really hard for Bowser to deal with. He is one of the largest characters in the game, so it makes a lot of sense to why that could be so hard. But we're definitely getting to see more of that. Bowser's at a really high percent now, but Matt really does not want to lose a stock, because especially in these group bat formats, it's very important to keep these. Constantly getting hit by Patooey. Matt is just throwing up all this chip damage, but Bowser can do the same thing. You know, Bowser's playing extremely well for how stressful of a situation he's been put in. Matt getting him to 200%, and the up throw will kill there. Alright, that's a great job by Manchester so far. We are now up a whole player. Us having six stocks and them having three. So it's important to say that the only thing I really know about this team is that they have a Diddy Kong. So I think with that, Matt has pretty good experience into Diddy Kong, with both Landon having a secondary Diddy Kong and Clay maining Diddy Kong. I think there's great things we could see. And there's no doubt in my mind that Grimbo's going to perform absolutely amazing out here in just a second. But we just got to see. We got to see what they end up throwing down at us. Because Diddy Kong played last night. Alright, so I guess we don't have to worry about this Diddy Kong for the last guy. So I'm curious to see who they're going to throw out then. Because Diddy Kong was the only character I think I knew. Unless they posted the characters in the Glec competition. I'll check that real quick. Because if they did, that'll give us some insight to what characters they have next. Let's see here. Nope. I don't believe we had the research. Unless I just don't see it. That's also a possibility. Nope, not seeing their potential roster anywhere. Alright. I guess we'll just wait to see. We'll wait to see together on who Matt will be facing. Looks like they're getting to the arena now. They'll be putting Matt will be playing against a Rob. If anybody else follows Matt on YouTube, then we know that Matt has insane gyro controls. So if Matt gets a hold of this projectile, I think we could see some really good clips come from Matt tonight. I love seeing how much knowledge Matt has with his character and how his character interacts with other characters' items and objects. It's really cool. And if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, I definitely recommend you guys go to his YouTube channel and check out the Rob clip he has. He only has a couple, so it's not hard to find. It's honestly an awesome watch. Anyway, this Rob's doing a really good job trying to zone out this Piranha Plant. Matt's still struggling to find a footing, but he's getting there. Has... Oh, reflecting the Patui. I wasn't expecting that at all. I didn't realize you could reflect Patui under Plat. I think that was some weird interaction too. Matt going for the call out. Almost getting it. Getting that call out. Barely killing. That was crazy. I was not expecting that to kill at such a low percentage. Alright. Matt trying to get these trades. Because Matt knows that if he can at least get a trade off, that somebody else will be able to take the stock as long as he takes at least one or two, which he's already taken the one. And he's getting ready to take a second one. Matt having an insane recovery there, avoiding getting spiked. Matt is doing a really good job recovering from when the Rob had done his first stock. Losing that stock, which is fine. Matt's coming back. I think Matt's got some music going or something. You'll see his head beating back and forth. Matt is in tune. Going for a call out with an up smash, but barely missing. Alright, it's a one stock situation. But we still have a whole other player behind. I feel like Grimbo could definitely get this last stock. We've seen him do it before, and he's just an insane player. Nothing that we haven't seen Matt do before. Ooh, armoring through it. Matt right now is just getting bullied off stage. That was an insane recovery, but he did get into the Raw side special. So we'll put our last guy against it, Rob. That Rob was insanely good, and I definitely think that Matt in a game three situation could do really, really good things against that, but he did what he could and he got him down to one stock. And at the end, in the grand scheme of things, that was what Matt was in there to do, was to take stocks. It'd been really cool if he won that, but now we have our last guy to throw in. And I'm not sure who we threw in already between our two guys, but it's looking like an Aug send, potentially. An Aug anchor. That's usually who we anchor, so who knows? Who knows? I'm kind of excited to see it. There's a chair. There was at one point a person. I'm not sure who it is no more, though. But with it being Rob, I think Rob is one of the harder matchups we have. I don't think we've ever had to deal with a Game & Watch. But with it being Rob, I believe the best pick we have, not by matchup, but by experience into the character, is Augment. So I'm curious to see what we throw in. Looks like they just kind of started without us picking yet. So it looks like we already have a character, or it looks like we have one of our guys locked in. Maybe they're not locked in. I see August coming across the room. Nobody's sitting down. They're bamboozling me. No, but on a real note, it's one stock that we're taking. Unfortunately, they're getting more data on us too. When we throw in one of our guys, it is an aug send. When we throw in one of our, with this being our last guy, I think it really just, it gives them information, which kind of sucks because going against August upon not going against August at all is terrifying. And August can really just sweep you without, if you haven't played him before. So I think that's really hard because August is honestly probably Manchester's, like, if we're going to put, I guess it's hard to say what Manchester's best is, right? But by golly, August is pretty close to being Manchester's best if he is, because his knowledge of the game and how well he plays it and how well he makes you play the game. August is amazing. August is also the number one player I'd recommend anybody trying to learn this game as well. He is such a good teacher. Going in really aggressive. I'm not sure Rob's really, like, how good this character is at zoning, especially since all he really has is gyro and laser has to charge. But this Rob is doing a really good job keeping you out and just keeping the pressure on, which I think is very important. But August is just so much better at closing in gaps and then keeping this close pressure that I feel like Rob doesn't want. So Aug already taking him to a high percent. Aug's only been hit a couple times. Taking the stock already. I feel like we maybe throw an Aug send for game two. That is Manchester taking game one against NDSU. And if I'm gonna be honest, I didn't really write that in there, so I don't even know what school that is. But that's gonna be us for game one. So I'm really excited to see if August plays, starts off game one, game two. Let me get a game counter in there. All right, and this is Nace, so I believe we're at 12 stocks. All right, so that was an amazing game by Aug. Looks like we're gonna send in Fleetwood, North Dakota State. Thank you, Freedom 500. That makes a lot of sense, now I think about it. Looks like we're gonna send Fleetwood in first. I always love sending in Fleetwood first. Not to say Fleetwood is annoying, but his character is extremely annoying. Nobody wants to just go in against Min Min. I feel like Min Min is just one of those characters that really annoys you, really, really makes you feel tilted as a player, like you can't do anything. And then in turn, you just really make bad decisions. So I always feel like Min Min as a character is just a really good send off the bat. And Fleetwood is also just an insane player. So I'm excited to see what he can do with that. People have talked about how they think that his Min Min is way better than his Steve was. And I think James has agreed at one point, but James still takes his Steve, to those who followed Manchester for a while, he still takes his Steve to other competitions. So if you ever see him at the Manchester Monday local, or any other local, any Odyssey event, I think is where you'll typically see James. But you have potential for seeing his Steve, which I think is always a blast to see. It's a character you see James enjoy. He's always having fun, and you can actually see him just, like, actually have, like, a blast with the character. And James is always just like laughing, having a good time while he plays. So it's really, really fun to play James too. Alright, let's getting into James Minman versus a Lucas. I have no idea how this matchup will play out. It doesn't sound that bad for Lucas though, because he does have PK Fire that just stretches across the stage. And I'm pretty sure doesn't has like a lot of priority as far as it being a projectile. Alright, James weaving through what Lucas could throw at him. Already has so much percentage on this Minmin. I mean, on this Lucas. Minmin is doing so much damage. It is just... Ooh! Getting that hit in. This feels... Oh my gosh, this feels so scary for this Lucas. Only getting James to 15% off the beginning, off the first stock. Definitely doing better right now. But now James has center stage and he has that space. Who knows what he's gonna do with it? James all the time talks about how good Minmin dash attack is, and you don't really understand how good it is until you see him use it 3 times in a row against a player. It's honestly kind of crazy. But man, James is doing such a good job. He might not even... Oh, I guess that's the commentator's curse. But James could potentially just 3-stock this round right here. Oh my gosh. Already taking stock number 2. Only at 84%. Getting these attacks in. Getting the damage. And getting the confirms. This laser seems to be really hard for this Lucas to deal with. I do believe it is also one of those moves that he can just use the magnet for, but I'm not 100% sure. And if that Lucas isn't sure, I'm sure he doesn't want to find out mid-game either. All right. Minmin being untouched. Lucas not being able to use the projectiles he wants either. This sounds like one of the most... This really just looks like probably one of the most annoying matchups in the game. This Lucas is not having a fun time, and I do not blame him either. I don't think I would want to take any of my really low priority projectile characters against Minmin at all. James doing an insane job. He's locked in right now. See everybody behind him laughing and having a good time. James only at 144%. Anything could kill, but this with James. Okay. Getting the 3-stock. James just had such good control on the stage. There was not much that Lucas player was given the chance to do. And James is really just good at walling people out. And that's just funny seeing that, you know, he used to play Steve, a character who could actually build the wall. But man, James has gotten just as good as building a wall with those arms. And he's done so much work. He's put so much work in this character, and it's really paying off. I see him in the lab all the time. And man, he's dominant. Yes, dominated, way to go, Fleetwood. Is dominant with this character. It's kind of sad thinking about it. I'm just a freshman coming in. It's like sad thinking that he's not going to be the Minmin player next year. We might have a new Minmin or whatever, but we're not going to have James no more, which is just going to be a weird feeling. But I guess we'll hit that when it hits. I think it's definitely cool that James is just enjoying himself right now. There's no pressure. There's no pressure from playing North Dakota State right now. He's just locked in. That was Lucas. They have a Rob. They have a Diddy Kong. I wonder what we're gonna see. I'm not sure how good Diddy Kong would go into Minmin or how good Rob would, but Minmin does have a reflector. It's okay. So I guess we're getting the Rob. I was gonna say Minmin has a reflector, so I'm not sure how this matchup would play out, but I feel like I feel like James understanding that this player is going to constantly try to throw brown projectiles. I see James reflecting a lot more than what he would in like a match up against like a character with a typical projectile. But as we saw with the Lucas player, the Lucas didn't have much of a chance to use his projectile at all. And Gyro is arguably one of the best, or the best projectile in the game, leading for Rob to do so much, but we just can't get off stage as Min Min. That's one big important thing, is Min Min can lack in that area, and that's just what we don't want. Not losing off stage yet. James still getting a feel for the Rob. Taking a stock off of that, I wasn't sure if that would kill or not, but that was actually really good on the Rob. James deciding to wait. James going into the stock a lot better than what he did last time. Almost getting a stock off them there, which is kind of crazy. Right now, James just needs this confirm so that he can almost get a little reset. Once again, this Rob is just really good at walling you out with projectiles, not giving you a chance. James not having much to go for the stock. Getting these stray hits, just getting this Rob upwards of percentages. And almost killing. Getting the up smash to take the stock. And this is still a huge lead, so even if even if James can take just one more, that's still dominant for Manchester. They're almost equal in percentages. And Min Min can cheese stocks quite. Ooh! Oh, that is unfortunate. James just barely falling off of the platform due to some hit stun cancel and just putting him in the way of that side B. That is really unfortunate. James's goal really is to just take this one stock to give the team better odds with less to work with. And that is not what James needs. That is unfortunate. Getting edge guarded. Just like I was saying, we were trying to avoid from last game. James did an amazing job though. Not much he could have done against that edge guard. Once he got hit, it was almost game over, but we can almost definitely expect to see August, because August did super well into that Rob. I can also see him sitting down right in front of the switch now, so that's the thing too. But August did insanely good into that Rob, and so we'll see what he can do this time. But I think he was only at like 20% when he took the Rob's last stock. Because for them, I believe that was their last stock. We are only one stock ahead, though. But I feel like that's not going to be too much for Manchester. Because, of course, we have just so many good people lined up in the back. We still have, you know, Landon, Duck, and the rest of the guys, too. So we get the August send. I'm really looking forward to see how August plays this matchup. I always love watching August play the Rob matchup, especially since August secondary's Rob. It's always fun to see somebody play their secondary or main. So August getting control of Gyro. Throwing it straight up. Gyro is one of those like projectiles that Rob really, really gets advantage of using. And if you throw straight up, it falls so slow. And so what a lot of players will do if they don't want to deal with it is just throw it straight up. That's just like something really cool to know. Aug is a tad bit behind in the stock, but of course, Aug picking it up quite fast. Trying to go for that percent. I feel like Aug was really going for an early stock right there, too. Aug has go. Almost killing off the side. Go meter is just so strong. I'm not sure which is stronger. Go meter or like, ooh, trying to get a straight hit. Getting the cancel from the gyro. August was so smart with that. That was crazy. August knew that that was gonna cancel because of that gyro and that the Rob was gonna try to punish him for such a laggy option. But it just wasn't because of that gyro. That was crazy. That was crazy knowledge from August. Aug not wanting to lose any more stocks. But this Rob wants to cheese at least one more, it looks. Aug getting the percent to his favor. Jackro barely hitting him. This feels like a game of tug of war between these two players. August catching the land. Oh, that was crazy. August catches the landing and takes the stock early. That was crazy from August. If he would have missed that, Aug could have potentially lost a stock. So that's one of those just terrifying situations. But man, Aug is so good at finding hits like those and really just punishing you hard. That as an example literally took a whole stock off of a straight hit. That was crazy. August is just goated with it. So now they have their Diddy player. That's all I know of. And I think somebody said that they had a Bowser Jr. in the Discord, so that might be something, which I think that's always fun to have, is a Bowser Jr. Because nobody knows how to play against Bowser Jr. Unless you play a lot online and you encounter them every once in a while. But overall, I think, you know, them having a Diddy is just cool for us, especially since we have such a good Diddy player, that being both Clay and Landon. But mainly Clay, of course, since we don't really see Landon play Diddy Kong anymore. Definitely fun to see what August could be faced with next. August having two stocks, I feel like August could definitely take out a whole other player before he loses his two, putting us in a similar situation last game where we have six and they have three. Because right now we do have eight, so we're up two stocks. They have six. But you can never count a team out, so you never know what they could throw at us as well. Definitely looking forward to see what if they have any, you know, like the tables turns type players, such as like a Bowser Jr. and such. I think that'd be really cool. All right, looks like they just got done with stage bands. Like we're going to Battlefield. August getting the tech and music ready. He is locked in and he's ready. All right, they're getting ready to start. It looks like we're going to see Kazuya. This is also another fun character because Manchester has a extremely good Kazuya. And so if you know Parzon, Mr. Parzon YouTube, there's Colin just this crazy Kazuya. We get the joy of playing him almost every day. So I'm excited to see what August does with his experience playing this character. Which August is really taking this patient, which is funny because you kind of do want to play these characters kind of patiently because they want to be in your face. So it's funny seeing August play it patiently. Aug does not want to lose a stock at all. That'd be very important for him to keep everything. Oh! Aug setting him straight to 120. That's actually kind of crazy. August hasn't been really touched yet. Straight to 50%. August catches, but doesn't kill. August kills. That was crazy. Game is now down. Restarts. What can Og throw at us? Player really just going for this damage. Og is going for these really quick put like mix-up type options. It's really cool. Og now has go meter though. So ooh, getting punished for the laggy option. August is almost at max rage with go. And if August can go into next stock with this, that's going to be extremely scary for this Kazuya. Ooh, barely dying. August having one stock left. And this feels fairly good for both the Kazuya and the Terry as far as them taking each other out. Ooh, barely getting hit. That slowed hitbox, that was really weird. They both, it's one stock versus one stock. What can this Kazuya do? Kazuya's going for just these early stocks, not these true confirms. Seems like they're fairly even now too. Kazuya going for some EGOF combos. Ooh, August going for a read, unfortunately gets punished for it and loses stock. So we are now going in two players to their one and a third. Is that a good way to put it? One and a third players? I'm not really sure. Og did insanely well. I think it was really unfortunate. I was wondering when Kazuya was going to side special from ledge. It's really unfortunate that when August went for a read that it happened. But August still took a lot of stocks, taking out the entirety, well, finishing off the Rob. I can't remember if that was two or three stocks. I think it was two. And then shaving two stocks off the Kazuya. August did great. August did insanely well. And now we just gotta throw in our next player, which it's looking like Manchester's very own Duck190 coming in with Diddy Kong. So this is going to be extremely fun. Haven't seen Duck play for a hot minute either, so I'm really looking forward, well, besides the beginning, but I'm really excited to see how they play against Kazuya. Especially since Diddy Kong's got a lot of good tools to keep Diddy Kong out. I feel like this could be really rough for Kazuya, but I don't know how confident Clay is into this matchup. So we'll really see what both players are capable of. It looks like they're getting the stage bands. Duck just got their controller in, so waiting for this. All right, let's see this Duck send. I definitely think that Clay has the potential to finish off this game. We got a card game to play after this too, so they better sweep. Alright, let's go Duck190. Going for some banana shenanigans on shield. I absolutely love watching how much control Duck has over his character and how well they use banana. Because it honestly is just really cool to see somebody as high level as Clay use their resources. Seems like the Kazuya is also struggling around banana. Went to reflect it earlier, but didn't really get anything. Ooh! Getting Demon God fisted, that was really scary. Duck not wanting to lose a stock right here. Ooh! That was crazy.
Diddy Kong wins.
That was insane. That combo was so cool. I look away for 1 second and I just see the down air fly out. Just the raw down air. That was insane from Clay. But now we're also up a whole guy. So we really do have a Clay to throw out at 3 stocks. So let's get a duck sweep going. But yeah, Clay the clean upper. Yeah, that was crazy. I was not expecting that at all. But that was really cool to hit. I've seen them use banana so many times in so many cool and fun ways that just ends games. It is actually like it's so atrocious when I think about it, because that character is just so good, and Clay is amazing at operating Diddy Kong. Just together, it's just not a healthy balance. It's too good at this game, I swear. All right, and we get to see the Diddy Kong Ditto, so this is gonna be fun. Who's gonna play better, really? I don't wanna say it's really who's better, because, you know, they're playing online. And, you know, each player deserves the benefit of the doubt. But I'm really excited to see what these players do. Both bananas are out. Both these players are just flying across the map right now. I got a mic in my way. I can barely... They're just... Bananas are flying. Monkeys are flying. Diddy Kong just throwing both bananas. Ooh, Duck just narrowly missing the punish. This is just such a weird match to watch. Clay going in. Like, Clay's also using a lot more of a side B than the other Diddy Kong. Just little things to note, really. This other Diddy Kong's doing an extremely, extremely good job as well. Taking our stock first. Alright. Duck narrowly claiming that stock from the up smash. Both these players are thinking the same exact thing, and I think it's so funny to watch it happen. Back going for some callouts, trying to get some combo off of these. Both of them exchanging bananas like their phone numbers. It's just crazy. Duck does have the other Diddy Kong's banana. As long as you keep your opponent's banana, they can't pull another one, but you can, I believe you can still pull yours. So that's... Ooh, going for some banana shenanigans. You love to see it. And when it hits, it's always just so cool to see. Unfortunately, Jordan's banana backfired. Both these players are just keeping each other up towards the same percentages, roughly. Ooh. And it's just weird interaction. Clay having the other Diddy Kongs. None of these combos are landing. Pretty much at the same exact percentages. Like, going in for both bananas. This is just such a funny matchup. Ooh, like getting the spike off. This is This is an even ditto between the two Diddy Kongs. Play doing some stuff that I saw them labbing the other day. This is one of those matches that just needs to be soaked in, I swear. Play is definitely going for a more passive approach, while this other Diddy Kong player is definitely more aggressive. Trying to get the opponent's banana. Tripping a couple times here. Still, they just continue to just get these trades and keep this almost even with each other. Dancing across the map. Both these players just also have insanely good neutral. That was a really weird interaction between the banana toss. That was actually like really, really weird. Ooh, almost claiming duck stock, and that'll do it. Manchester has 3 stocks. North Dakota State University now only has 1. I think both Diddy players are fairly even as far as, you know, how they played, especially seeing how they were pretty much close the entire time. I definitely feel like it was just weird for both players. Definitely felt a bit more foreign to Clay. I don't think we've had a. I think that was the first Diddy Kong ditto that we've had on stream for Manchester, so that was really cool. But Clay did an insanely good job into that Diddy Kong player. And I believe Clay took 3 stocks because they were at 4, I believe. So, you know, Clay still keeping the pressure on, keeping the weight onto the other team. They still don't know who we're going to throw out, and we have we almost have an advantage being able to throw out anybody that, you know, we can pretty much see fit. We have Landon, we have Grimbo, and I believe that's it between our players for A team. But we just have thrown so much that we're able to put towards this Diddy Kong from the other team. And so I'm curious to see what we will do. Especially since it's 1 stock, but this Diddy Kong player is at a level where, you know, they ended up beating Clay. So definitely giving them the benefit of just being a crazy player. Because they beat our crazy player. So definitely think that throwing Matt could be a good send. Because, you know, Diddy Kong is very light. On top of Diddy Kong being very light, you know, Grimbo just knows the matchup. I feel like that's something that we can say for pretty much every Madden team, though, is that they know the matchup. But play hits hard, and but can also get comboed to death by Diddy Kong, so maybe not. But then we also have our Mii Sword Fighter that we haven't seen today specifically, but that's definitely a good sense because Landon understands how to play Diddy Kong because that's his secondary. So I'm definitely seeing. Oh, we have someone sit down. And looks like it's going to be Landon. Landon is going in. Definitely excited to see Landon play. Not too excited to see that he just gets to play against 1 stock. I love watching Landon play Mii Sword Fighter. And I don't think 1 stock. Good enough to satisfy me. So, just unfortunate that Landon just gets to play against the last stock, but still definitely exciting to watch Landon, you know, go against such a good player too. All right, let's transition. We are up 2 stocks. It is Lana versus Diddy Kong. This will be the match that decides whether we go to game three or not. Looks like Lana's running his normal moveset of the Ninja Star. Actually, wait, I don't know if he has Chakram. Okay, there we go, Chakram. Already hitting some damage off. Playing around banana extremely well. That's what I think, like, the Diddy Kong. Ooh! Diddy Kong, outgas him. Cheese that stock. That would have been crazy if that down air hit. Brandon really just keeping his space now. Throwing shotgun straight at the banana. That's so smart. Catching it off the shield. Landon also just has a really good knowledge of how banana works as well, which I think is really cool. Seems like this Diddy player really just excels from these close situations. And Mii Brawler is not the best when it comes to these like boxing matches. And so definitely keeping this Diddy Kong out is very important. Clay is another thing to note, you know, even matching against Clay, just having two bananas, I feel like it's just that's a lot for a match. Landon keeping the space. Ooh. Landon recovering just narrowly. Ooh. Okay, Landon losing his first stock. Still has two to work with, and the Diddy Kong is extremely high percent, so I feel like if he hits that power thrust, I can't remember what the move's exactly called, but one more power thrust, I think it's going to be over for this Diddy Kong. And Landon is really good at conditioning you and hitting you with that power thrust. Down air killing, right? Down air not yet killing. That is crazy. And not wanting to get reversal. And the Diddy Kong accidentally air dodging. That is extremely unfortunate. But that is going to be Manchester taking game two. So that's a W for Manchester, and I think that's honestly just an insanely cool match, especially being able to see the Diddy Kong Ditto. Let me pull up our match schedule for the rest of the week. I know it's weird because we do have spring break next week, but I can tell you what we guys have. All right, so it's looking like we have Overwatch versus Albion Thursday at 8 p.m. Definitely go check them out. Their season's actually been really good. And then the next Smash game is going to be Smash versus Full Sail Thursday at 8:30 p.m. That's going to be our A-team. Thank you. Thank you, Adrian. Great job, man. Yes, we are going for first place in this NACE Super League. And I'm extremely excited to see how well we perform. We've already taken games off of the best schools in the world, one being Fishers. So it's just really cool to see how well we're doing, how well our players are performing. Our A team is just, you know, even our B team, our players, all of them, even C team, D team, we're all just, I'm not going to speak for myself, but they're all so good. And they all have just such a unique perspective on this game that make them all valuable and unique in its own way. And I think it's really cool. Just talking to any player about Smash, just what the things they can tell you and how passionate everybody on the esports team is about this program. It's really cool. Nice commentary, Alex. Thank you, Scrub Mom. I really appreciate it. Anyway, that's going to conclude the stream tonight. If you want to check into our next match, it's going to be Thursday at 8:30, Smash versus Full Sail. That's going to be extremely fun for all of us. Because I believe, I don't know. I think we have like a former player there, so that's really cool to think about. Anyway, I do believe that's the last one. Thursday match, 8:30. I believe that's the last one, and I don't think we're going to. You're not going to see anything next week. Next week is spring break, of course, and then past that, I believe you guys get to see us on our regular schedule, with Thursday being Nace and Saturday being Gleck. I do believe Gleck kickstarts back then that week, so I'm not sure. If not, I'll tell you Thursday in like 14 days. Yeah. Oh my gosh, that's actually a long time. I didn't even realize. That is a long time. That's a long time without Smash. That's a long time without Ace. Anyway, I'm Alex. That's going to conclude the Manchester stream. Make sure to tune in Thursday. Make sure to tune in for Overwatch. Give them support and love. And that's going to conclude. See you guys.